Good day, students. So we know that DSP processors are broadly classified into two types: fixed point DSP processors and floating point DSP processors. Fixed point DSP processors are designed to support fixed point arithmetic operation. So the series of TMS320C54X series are nothing but fixed point DSP architecture developed by Texas, and the architecture that is supposed it is supported for this processor is Harvard architecture. So when we look into this architecture as a whole, we can study one by one about, or we can study in brief about the various parts of this fixed point processor. To begin with, one program and three data memory spaces with separate buses, which provides simultaneous access to program instruction and two operands and enable writing of result at the same time, are available. So we can see that we have separate addresses or separate program memory for program address generation and data address generation. And then we also have a memory for external interface and peripheral interface. Part of the memory is implemented on chip and consists of combinations of ROM, RAM and single access RAM. Transfers between the memory spaces are also possible. So let us start first with the bus structure. The provision of multiple buses to provide simultaneous access to various parts of the memories are the peripherals. So we can see here that this is a particular memory unit, and here also we have memory and external interfaces and peripheral interfaces, and this will be a part of your CPU where all the operations are being done, and data has to be moved from the memory onto the interfaces as well as to the CPU. So this movement of data is supported by a broad range of buses, starting from PAB, PB, CAB, CB, DAB, DB, EAB and EB. So these are the set of buses that are available for fixed point processors. So as we see here, four pairs of 16-bit buses. So we have four pairs, and each pair is said to be a 16. Each bus is 16-bit buses, which consists of an address bus and a data bus. So AB represents address bus and just B represents the data bus. So the program bus pair PAB, PB, which carries the instruction code from the program memory. So as we can see here, from the program memory, the instruction code is being taken over by this particular PAB and PB. Similarly, the three data bus pairs, so program bus pairs are PAB and PB. The data bus pairs are CAB, CB, DAB, DB, EAB, EB, which are interconnected within the various units within the CPU. So the CPU contains various units, and for movement of data between these units, we use these data buses. In addition, along with that, these pairs CAB, DAB are used to read from the data memory, whereas EAB and EB carries data to be written to the memory. So to write to memory, we use these, and EAB and EB is used to write the data to the memory. As a whole, we can see the central processing unit consists of all these: a 14-bit ALU, accumulators, two 40-bit accumulators, barrel shifter, a 17x17 bit multiplier, a 40-bit adder, a compare, select and store unit, exponent encoder, a address generation unit DAGN, and a program generation unit PAGN. The ALU performs 2's complement arithmetic operation as well as bit level boolean operation on 16-bit, 32-bit and 40-bit words. Accumulators, there are two accumulators A and B, which store the output from the ALU or the multiplier or the adder block and provide a second input to the ALU. Each accumulator is divided into three parts. We can see that the bits 32 to 39 are reserved for guard bits, 31 to 16 are higher order word and then 0 to 15 bits are lower order word, which can be stored and retrieved individually. So barrel shifter. So barrel shifter is a part of the CPU which is used to perform shifting operations. It provides a capability to scale the data during an operand read or write. No overhead is required to implement the shift needed for scaling operation. This barrel shifter is capable of producing a left shift of 0 to 31 bits. For left shift, we can perform 0 to 31 bits, or a right shift we can perform from 0 to 16 bits on the input data. Next to the important part of the CPU is a multiplier or adder unit. The kernel of the DSP device is, as we have seen, it's a MAC unit, which is called as multiplier bar adder unit. So the MAC unit of TMS320C54X devices, it performs 17 into 17 component multiplication with a 14-bit addition effectively in a single instruction cycle. Moving on to the memory, internal memory, and the registers needed for storing these data. The 54XS memory is organized into three individually selectable spaces, as we have seen already: program memory, data memory, and I/O spaces. So all devices have RAM and ROM. The on-chip RAM for these processors is organized in pages having 128 word location on each page. The 54X processor have number of CPU registers. So we have more number of CPU registers to perform operand addressing and computation. A list of these internal CPU registers with the peripheral registers and their corresponding addresses are given over here. To highlight a few, STO0 is a status register 0 and STO1 is status register 1. And we can also see a stack pointer register whose memory location is 7, stack point memory location is 18. Thank you.